The short answer to that question is it depends. The long answer, I'll explain. Osmosis riddled hull, to buy or not to buy? I got this one in the DMs from Anthony. So Anthony, this one's for you. To start with, osmosis is water getting into the hull between the layers of fiberglass and causing an acidic chemical reaction that creates bubbles on the outside of the surface. You'll usually find it on a boat built in the late 80s and early 90s. Occasionally you'll get confused with bubbles inside the layers of antifoul, and the quickest way to check is to pop one of those bubbles and smell a strong vinegar smell. Osmosis is usually caused by the choice and quality of resin used in the original layup. Because it's been such a problem over the last 30, 40 years, most quality manufacturers know what to use and how to avoid it. It's very uncommon to see it on a late model, well-built boat. Generally, if a hull hasn't developed osmosis in the first 5 years of its life, it's very unlikely that it's going to later in life. So what about the boats that do have osmosis? The first question I'd be asking is how the hull is constructed. If that hull is cored and there's an osmosis bubble big enough to penetrate through and let water into the coring, you could potentially create delamination of the hull, which is going to be a major problem. If the outside hull is straight fiberglass and there's no coring, it's going to be less of an issue. How would you pick it up if it's delaminating on a cored hull? The quickest and easiest way is a little tap tap with the hammer, which we all know is quite an easy test. If it's a late model boat, say 5 years old, and it's already developed osmosis, that's when you're going to have to start thinking about stripping it back to bare and completing a barrier coat of the correct grade resin that doesn't allow water through, so you don't constantly have problems with osmosis throughout the life of the boat. That's a pretty major exercise, so maybe that's a showstopper. It's very important that you don't allow it to be spot repaired, because those areas that have been repaired are going to be susceptible to not getting osmosis, but the rest of the hull can still generate osmosis. So throughout the life of the boat, you're going to be constantly repairing it. If it hasn't caused any structural damage over the last 30, 40 years, the hull's not cored, then most people will just leave it and monitor it over time. It might come up each time someone tries to sell the boat at survey, but it's not really a deal breaker. Being that the boat's probably 30 or 40 years old, you're more likely gonna have bigger fish to fry, like things such as engines, electrical, that are gonna still be original, and that's where I'd be spending my money. To recap, on an older boat, depending on the construction, I'd be less concerned, but on a newer boat, it's more likely a red flag. If you're unsure, it's always best to get it checked by a professional. Make sure you smash the subscribe button and give us a like while you're there, so you don't miss out on any more of our content.